What's up, dudes and dudettes, this is Additions here, and today I've got another Ghost gameplay commentary. So today I've got really exciting news, and basically what it is about is updates to the competitive support for Ghosts, and also just updates in general. So on to the news. So Infinity Ward's posted something on their forums, and what they talked about was supporting competitive and different rules and stuff that they'd implement, and also just problems that they were going to fix. So, as most of you know, the game at its current state is not very good. It has a lot of problems, especially for competitive, and it needs to be saved. So, I really like that Infinity Ward is taking time to actually address these problems, and are going to actually fix them. So the first part of the article here says, "The team at Infinity Ward wants to express our sincere thanks for the recent dialogue we have had with the competitive community. Each constructive conversation, message board post, and Reddit thread has had a positive impact in our development process. We're always lurking and listening." So basically, they're just thanking you guys for the feedback, and everybody's been saying they're addressing the problems of the game, and now they're actually going to be taking steps to fixing these problems. So, moving on, the second paragraph in the article goes like this. "As we tweeted last week during UMG Philly, we'd like to announce some updates we plan to roll out as soon as possible to support competitive Call of Duty based on your feedback. These will appear as both hot fixes and title updates in the coming weeks, alongside planned changes to the areas of Ghosts affecting all players, such as spawns. As a guiding principle, development priority is assigned to those issues which we deem to have the largest immediate impact or those affecting the broadest group of players. We'll keep the upcoming improvements to Call of Duty Ghosts page updated in this respect. Watch out for more info coming soon." So they're just talking about more stuff about how they're going to fix it, and just to keep up to date with what they're doing. And so moving further down the page, it says, "Regarding esports specifically in the immediate future, we aim to," and then it shows a list. "Restrict ghillie suits in competitive rules. Restrict tracker sight in competitive rules. Restrict danger close in competitive rules. Disable third-person spectating in private matches. Add a kill feed to broadcaster mode. Address broadcaster mode stability." And then in parentheses it says squash crash bugs. And then moving further on. "Additionally, we're committed to delivering the below in no particular order." And then rules. "Removal of split screen in private match when esports rules are enabled. Add esports rules to clan v clan playlist." That means league play. "Open clan v clan playlist to allow solo player entry and mixed clan teams. Modify dead silence amplify functionality." Which is so awesome, dude. Oh my god. Esports rules to clan v clan. There's gonna be league play. It's going to be awesome, and I can't wait. So moving Further down, they also want to make modifications to Search and Destroy. So it says, resolve the diffuse timer animation discrepancy, modify the diffuse time sound effects in the diffuse process is if the diffuse process is canceled. And then broadcaster mode, add game action overlays where needed, in parentheses, flag captures, etc. Resolve the leaderboard's red death indicator delay. Roll over a player in scoreboard highlight arrow in minimap. And then the last one on the list is new platform. And it says investigating the addition of Xbox One LAN support, which is also awesome for teams like me, like version 2, who are on Xbox One and are waiting to scrim other Xbox One teams. But we can't do that right now because everything's on the 360. Nobody's going to be scrimmaging on the three on the one. So the final thing, final paragraph on this post is, we realize this doesn't cover every request made to date, only those we are confident we can deliver at this time. We'll keep you posted regarding future updates. We are committed to providing the best possible multiplayer experience we can, and will continue to work on improvements to make it better. Please keep the communication coming. Thanks for your support, and we'll see you online. So, all of this is great news, and I'm really happy with Infinity Ward. And, yeah, that's basically the end of the commentary. I can post the article in the description, even though I just read it to you. But, yeah, I hope you enjoyed this gameplay commentary. I'll see you dudes and dudettes later. This has been Additions. Follow me on Twitter at additions_v2. And I'll see you dudes and dudettes later. Bye.